Should they catch us and dispatch us to those separate work camps?
Please,
you know.
give it up for my beautiful, beautiful wife, Sherri. She's been playing music much longer than I have, but that was the first time she's ever had to do it without her family or anybody up there with her, so give her a fucking hand. So, I want to give you guys a little bit of a precursor to this show. Because there's so many ridiculous guitar parts, which only Jake and people like that who are actually good can play live, I can't do it. I'm not that good. So there's only a certain amount of songs that I can actually play, but I think I've concocted a pretty good set list for tonight. I think it's good enough for you guys. You guys are rad, by the way. You guys think I'm gonna poop my pants or something like that. So, unfortunately, as I was saying, I can't really take requests. We have a set, set list, but I think it spans all the eras. We're gonna play a few songs from all our records. Including that one that doesn't officially exist. We're actually going to play We Being the Royal We. So who's to say we? I am going to play a few songs tonight that I've never played ever. They've never been played by Say Anything under any circumstances. Except for when they were recorded, obviously. That's how I had to play them. This is one of them. It's from our second record, In Defense of the Genre. Today I sat and smoked myself to cancer.
Just don't use that.
Bulls are you allowed to drink?
Seven.
Eight. Between seven and eight. It's okay. Did anybody purchase on the last record? Before I play this next one, I have to say, Playing songs with singing in there is the thrill of my life. I never have more fun than when I play with singing in. But these acoustic shows, they're competing. With a puppy right now. This is like receiving a paycheck. I don't know if I can equate this to any other joy besides puppies and paychecks. That also is the unspoken of sex, yes. All the words in my mouth.
Was indivisible. Never mind how my taste. reflects a disturbing edible complex. It's not awkward, girl. The compliments are coming in. You're no witch, you're no witch. You're with better fashion sense. Born with decency. And I'm building up my confidence. Respect to your work. You're an artist. I'm a silly jerk. I think that dynamic could work.
So worth it!
I have a total crush on you. No joke, I started shedding slutty girls. My space in my collection, acquired through shallow misdirection. As I try tonight, let's go stop daring me to try. I feel alive tonight, possibility that I'm your guy. Do I suffer from dyslexia?
Yeah.
Sherri, please. This next one hasn't been played since I was 17 or 18 years old. Are you guys familiar with the record that we don't acknowledge? I'm not even going to say your name. You can say it. Have you gotten past the second track at least? Imagine if someone took a snapshot, like a Polaroid shot of you at your most awkward moment of being about 17 and 3/4. Oh, thank you. Okay. Well, this one's I wrote this song about an area in my town where all the rich kids live. So, to be honest, my parents were not poor, but there was a particular area where there was a large douche center. I don't think it has anything to do with that. This one's called Showdown At P-Town.
Beware the city turns to trees. Nothing comes for free. Let's see just how involved you can be to me. So far from Rome.
We're gonna have my wife out for this one. What do you guys think of our last record?
It was awesome!
Remix it?
Yeah.
Turntable and all that shit. Just me getting down with that kind of dubstep sound. It's like a brownish poo-poo cup.
There's no one who matches like you. So give
guys. This is so fucking awesome.
He's good. Yeah.
You guys tired yet?
No!
That's good. We got another half of the set. Are you guys excited about our new record? Has anybody done any research into the songs that have been kind of peripherally released?
Narcissist!
Yes, there's a lot of those, right? You know? There's almost more of those than actual released. This is one of those that we released as a B-side for our record, Israel Boy. I think I'm going to get some flack for this.
No way!
But me and... Because there are people who... Just listen. Me and my friend John, when we were like 17 years old, drove into the worst part of Los Angeles. And if you know anything about Los Angeles, you know there's...
Beautiful.
There's some poo-poo, gee-gee parts. And then there's the... You're going to get killed. They will literally shoot, yes. Yes, exactly. Crenshaw District and such. And we drove there just for fun to see if we would get killed. I'm still here, so it was a successful outing, but I did write a song about it.
You too.
And it's called Slumming It With John. Straight this far, right out of town, southeastern down, inside my junky car. But when we got there, all we saw were more malls and marble mansions. And then we'll parks with city blocks proclaim the great expansion. It's so beautiful, garbage, they cleared it up already. Tears roll out the eyes, and though I cry, I hold the real soul. Here's for why we're fat and lazy. every little gumball, don't let's go crazy. This is so pointless, it actually holds up our evolution. Sing it to the bastards!
Free yourself from mental prostitution!
Yeah. We recently signed,
EBR!
We recently signed to the most amazing label in the world. They're called Equal Vision Records. Okay, let me give you a little snapshot of life before Equal Vision Records. There was one guy at the label who happens to be our manager now who really loved and believed everything we did. Everyone else sues.
Here, here!
Unidentifiable, generic men in suits. And they honestly were not okay with anything besides selling as many records as Kesha. Who is she? I don't know who she is. I was told someone sent me a note before. But the truth is, and now we're on a label. Now we're on a label that's been operating for many years, supporting bands who like to do their own thing. And I think it's pretty evident by the chicanery that you're witnessing right now that I like to do my own thing. Same with us who do our own thing. And really, they're here tonight. I mean, people from the Equal Vision are here tonight. They honestly looked at our band and they said, we will do anything to make sure that you have the utmost respect and you get to do whatever whatever excites you on a creative level. They literally, so I hope that you enjoy our next record because we made it under the circumstances for the first time in 6 or 7 years where there was no pressure to do anything but be creative and enjoy yourself while making music. That's thanks to those guys at Equal Vision. I don't know what they are. Somebody raise their hand.
Bill! Derek?
Well, you're not, but you're beautiful. I mean, you have a good look to you.
Girl, girl!
You're attractive, but I don't know if you work.
Tuck it in.
This is the single from our next record. It's called... This one's called Say Anything.
Rock.
got you, and you can. But if I was brave, I'd climb up to you on the mountain, the legend to drink from the fountain, spouting lies.
So why?
The horrible beast they commission, steering me away from my mission.
Smoke myself to a place of concern.
I have one more song.
That's not enough! Eloise!
Speculate as to what the song is.
Eloise! Or Narcissist! Narcissist!
I'm just gonna stand here until I hear someone sing the song.
Follow my phone.
his acoustic shows mean so much to me. Well, I have to say that's the shit, you know what I mean?
My band's very unsuccessful.
We get out there, we dance around.
I do.
But it really, I don't know if I can do this context.
Bass players aren't that good. That's true.
But it really means a lot to you guys at the very core, the stripped down core of the songs. You guys still know all the words in it, apparently. To watch me by myself just stand up here and play these songs.
You're an
asshole! Thank you so fucking much. Thank you. Can I give a little more acoustic?
You can forgive me. Dun, dun.
small.